Hello, this is David with entry number 1032-31. I'm here in the apartment getting ready to zone off and go to bed. It's been a relatively long day, but a very informative day. I had a one-on-one class with a class that is normally four students, and what I wanted to talk about in that class was actually a bit of a selfish topic, but I'm extremely curious about the subcultures here in Japan, of which there are quite a few. And the most interesting one to me is something called host clubs or host bars. And I can't remember if I've already discussed this, but I'm going to talk about it again anyway because it happened today. Basically, a host club is where you will go into a bar or something, and you basically pay a fixed rate per hour, and it's usually quite a lot, like $30 to $40 an hour, and you basically are served alcohol by a woman or a man, depending on which version you go into, because they do play for both sexes here. Although, of course, men are the men version, or the woman host version is a lot more popular. And you basically get your own personal host that sits with you and talks to you and laughs and flirts and basically does X, Y, except for Z. And it's a very interesting service that is provided here to the Japanese clientele. I think it's actually pretty cool. I haven't gone to any of them because my Japanese isn't good enough to hold a conversation for very long. I could probably do like a 10-minute chat and then I would bounce out of there. But I've heard some people spend many, many, many hours, up to 4 hours at some of these places, and spend hundreds of dollars. It's a very interesting concept in a country where physical connection is getting less and less, personal connection is becoming less and less, but people are still craving it in a very real way. So in order to satiate that craving of human-to-human contact, people are paying out the nose for it, where they could obviously work at interpersonal connection and get good at talking to other people, but instead they seem to be fixated or seem to be satiated by paying for it instead, which I can kind of see the merit in it, but you know, of course it's pretty sad. But I just find it very, very fascinating about this kind of these subcultures of hosting. And there's also something called cabaret in Japanese, which is not a little similar to cabaret in French, but it's more risque, I would say. There's sometimes nudity involved. It's sometimes closer to a strip club than it is cabaret. And there is sometimes, or quite often, there's physical touching involved, where it's men on the women, or men can touch the women. So it's a very, very interesting kind of culture, and I'm very fascinated by it. I don't think I'll ever like go to those kind of host bars, but I am very curious about learning more and more about like what kind of people go there, why they go there, how nice is it. I think it's a very common thing here in Japan, and I don't blame them, because this is kind of society that they have here is not conducive to like meeting new people, in my opinion. But anyway, that's it for today. Thanks for watching, and I'll talk with you soon. Bye.